Hey guys, it's your friend Kat here again. Today we're going to do a two-part video of this very creepy clown, Ronald McDonald himself. This is a two-part video. First, we're going to turn into Ronald McDonald, and then what if the food from the Happy Meals that Ronald snacked on turned him into something creepier than he already is? Demonic, evil-looking Ronald McDonald with fangs and everything. Sorry if this disturbs your dreams and causes nightmares, but I had to do it for Halloween. First, we're gonna put a wig cap on because I do not have red hair. I wish I did, like Ariel, the shade of red that Ronald McDonald's hair is, but I don't. Then I'm gonna flatten my eyebrows down. You guys know the drill. Put a layer of glue, wait for that to get tacky, then a layer of powder. I do this about 4 times for my brow hairs. It depends on how thick your brow hairs are, on how many layers you want to do to make your brows flat so that you could paint on top of them. Looks like someone snatched them brows away. Just shaved them off while you're trying to have some nice dreams. Once they are flat and dry, we're gonna get a white eyeliner pencil to do the outline of the clown nose and mouth. Getting this white cream paint, it is my favorite face base for any white makeup look. This is from Makeup Forever. It's their cream white face base. I got a brush at first to get the detail, fine lines around the nose and the mouth to make sure we don't smear it everywhere like cream cheese on a bagel. Then I got my fingertips. To apply this on the rest of my face, the warmth of your fingertips is going to give even coverage around your face. Again, this is the best face base, in my opinion, on the market. We're gonna do your face and your ears. You could get a white aqua paint to do your ears and your neck. We wanna get to about where the collar of a costume would be. If you wanna body paint a costume, that would be amazing, but I bought one. And then once you have the white face paint down, we're gonna get a black eyeliner to put in our waterline and to do the little dash marks on the bottom, the little diamonds on the bottom of our eye. I'm just getting a black liquid eyeliner pen to do those little diamonds of the classic clown look, especially of Ronald McDonald. Then with a black aqua paint and a very fine brush, I am doing Ronald McDonald's eyebrows. They're very thin and tiny. He definitely plucks his brows way, way, way too high above his head. And I do about 2 layers of that and then go in with more detail and more pigment with a eyeliner pen to make sure we look very surprised to see children as Ronald McDonald. Just fine-tuning this makeup, putting another layer of white face paint to make sure it's super pigmented, and doing a small tiny black eyeliner on the eyes. You could also get some mascara. I would have done that if I thought of it, to put on my lashes. Then with some red aqua paint, I am painting his nose. This is from Wolf Brothers. Has a little bit of a waxy consistency that's very pigmented on the nose, and we can't forget the mouth. Ronald McDonald has this creepy mouth that looks like he just bit into someone and they're bleeding from their mouth down their chin. That's what it reminds me of. Once you're done with that, we could put the costume on, which is super difficult because it's a onesie that includes feet and gloves with the outfit. I found this on Etsy. I'll list it down below along with all the products in this video. It's very tight fitting. And we're gonna put on this red wig to really become the essence of Ronald McDonald. Now we're completely done with this Ronald McDonald makeup transformation, digging into our Happy Meal, enjoying all the delicious fast foods that could make some people sick depending on what your diet's like, and turning into this devilish, creepy clown. In the second part of this video, I'm gonna show you how to make this amazing mouth. It's very creepy, so sorry if this scares you, but let's start off being this clown. Take this costume off because I cannot hold makeup with these gloves. I just can't do it. I can't even hold the makeup brush with the gloves. So I got some matte black eyeshadow with a very tiny brush. Do some wrinkles around the face. Give him some expression. Give him some like creases around his eyes to make him look a little bit more sinister and mad and angry and upset that someone's about to take his Happy Meal. Blending that out with a clean blending brush. Then we're gonna get a makeup remover wipe to start removing the mouth area of Ronald McDonald. This honestly, me smearing the makeup makes it look creepier. I don't know why, but you get some gelatin, or I got third degree, which is similar. You mix equal parts of A and B to get this. And what those were that I'm gonna stick into it are fake fingernails that I cut into tooth-like dagger fangs. Yes, this is what I do in my spare time, kids. I take my fake fingernails, don't apply them to my hands, but apply them to my face after I cut them into sharp-looking weapons. Please, if you're too young to cut things into weapon-like objects, have your parent help you. But this reminds me of an anglerfish, and I put that third degree above my upper lip and on the very bottom of my chin while sticking those fake fingernails that are our fangs now into the third degree before it sets. Again, if you do this with gelatin, please make sure it's not scalding hot to where it burns your actual skin. Then I got this cream blush from Mayron. I'm going to use this to color the gums on my teeth. You know gums, they're bright and pink. This one's gonna be a little bit more dingy. I'm just doing that as the base on the upper and bottom layers of gums, reaching the ends of my mouth, then getting the darker brown cream paint from the same palette to do some like dirt and shadow in between these gums to make it look dark and sinister, give it more detail, make it look more realistic, and have it go down towards the fangs as well so that it doesn't look like just clay with plastic in our face. Getting some black aqua paint to paint inside the mouth. Now this is gonna get a little messy. You could definitely get some of this accidentally on those fake teeth. You could just wipe that off later. But once it's all blackened inside of our mouth to make it look hollow, big, and open, like a real mouth about to chomp down on someone. That sounds creepy. We're gonna get a Midnight Death Wheel palette with this yellow paint to have these dingy, yellow, gross teeth. Painting those teeth, you don't have to paint all the teeth, just most of it yellow to make it look like he has been drinking coffee or they're just dirty and dingy from eating things that are very mysterious and creepy. Then getting that red aqua paint that we used before to paint his mouth, but painting a new mouth around these gums and fangs. Who would have known that fake press-on fingernails would be so creative? With that same aqua paint, we are painting scratch marks into Ronald McDonald's forehead. I know that's very creepy and scary, but we are gonna spell out the words, "I'm loving it." Do some dots. You even get some fake blood to really, you know, make sure that there's drip marks or whatever accident he's been in. From the lettering on his teeth, just smear on there a little bit. You can even dab some on the side of his mouth. Maybe he has some leftovers from his lunch. I even got it on my hand and act like fingerprints, like I've been in some sort of accident. Did it across my neck, going all out with the fake blood. There is such thing as too much fake blood, so don't go overboard. But I am going to put in some wide-out contact lenses because wouldn't it be scary if this evil clown had all white eyes? I think it would. So this step is optional, but once we are done with that, we have completely turned into this evil, demonic-looking Ronald McDonald clown. What would happen if the food he ate just turned him into something even crazier and creepier? I hope I didn't ruin anyone's childhood today. Again, I'm sorry if you're afraid of clowns. I really want to do this as my finale, final look for the Halloween season when this is uploaded. If it's not Halloween now, cool. You're not in the best holiday, in my opinion, yet. But now it's time for me to turn back into myself. Thank you all so much for watching. I really, really, really do appreciate it. If you do this makeup or any makeup from my YouTube channel, please post it on Instagram and tag me, #CatSketch. You guys inspire me so much to keep on keeping on the grandma of YouTube. I've been on here 10 years. I can't believe that. What is life? Leave a comment down below on what videos you would love to see after Halloween for some video ideas, because I'm still going to be celebrating Halloween year-round on my channel by turning into creepy, cool, imaginative, creative things. So subscribe to this channel to see those. And I love you all. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!